What is going on, guys? Welcome to Greggle's TV Daily, your source for daily tech news. Make sure you subscribe so you know what's going on in the world of tech. Hope you're having a fantastic day. I woke up at 2:30 in the morning and I could not fall back to sleep. So I've been up since 2:30 in the morning. I'm like dragging right now. I'm on fumes, but doesn't stop me from doing my video. We got a couple of news stories and a couple of questions. So let's dive into the tech news. The first couple of stories are deals. So the first one is the Galaxy Tab S8 Plus. This is supposedly the second best deal going on currently that it's ever had. You can grab an S8 Plus 128 gig with 8 gigs of RAM for $834 right on Amazon and get it delivered, for me anyway, as early as tonight. So check that deal out. It is linked down below, $834 for the 128. Eight delivered as early as tonight, tomorrow, aka depending upon where you live. The other deal is a Galaxy Z Fold 3, my main phone that I currently use, and you can get it for, look at that price, $14.99. I wish this was the price that it came out originally at. And you can also grab the 512 for $100 more at $15.99. So really good deals on Amazon, basically delivered as early as a day or two. So check those deals out. If you want, been waiting for to get the Galaxy Z Fold 3, those are really, really nice deals. Next up is about the Google Pixel 7 phone, and I would hold up my Pixel 7 phone, but my wife currently has it. She's in Vegas at the BTS concert, so she loves BTS right now, so she's doing all that stuff and going crazy for them, and she's borrowing the Pixel to take photos and videos with instead of her Z Fold 3. She has her Z Fold 3 with her, but she also has the Pixel 6 Pro with her as well. But that doesn't stop us from talking about the Pixel 6 phone and the cameras that will be on the back. Now, this is a little bit of a disappointment coming from this story, so check this out. This is coming from Yogesh, and he's saying, we will most likely see the same optics, aka cameras, on the Pixel 7 and 7 Pro that the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro had. Sensors might get some optimization. The rest of the magic will be done by the software, and it seems like a lot of companies are doing this. Didn't Samsung basically just kind of do this with their Galaxy S22 Ultra, where they like improve the software and basically leave the camera sensors the same versus the previous generation? And it looks like, I know Google has done this in years past as well with like the Pixel, I don't even know, was it 2, 3, and 4, or 5, all had the same camera. And then when they finally got to the 6, they changed it. So it looks like they're gonna do the same thing with the 7, give you better optimization, basically the same camera lenses. But it all adds to it. Like, why can't they also just do that to the 6? Hopefully they will. If you have a 6 and you're not gonna upgrade, they give you those same improvements that the Pixel 7 and 7 Pro will have. That's your news for today. Your question of the day is, what is the best camera phone in the market, at least in your eyes? Let me know in the comments down below. For me, it's still the Pixel 6 Pro in terms of taking photos, videos. It's either the Galaxy S22 Ultra or the iPhone 13 Pro Max, at least in my eyes, for the phones I've personally used. Let me know about your thoughts in the comments down below. With that said, let's jump into the Q&A portion of the video and drop that beat. First question comes from Tevin C. Do you like the speakers on the S22 Ultra versus the older S and Note models, especially the Note 20 Ultra? Also, do you think the Vivo Fold cameras are better than the Z Fold 3 cameras? Let's answer the last one first. I haven't seen any examples of the Vivo X Fold versus the Z Fold 3. But with that said, the Vivo X Fold does have, and on paper, it has better cameras, so I expect it to have better cameras overall. But once I get the phone, I'll let you guys know. And then beyond that, S22 Ultra having better speakers than the older phones. I don't have those older phones, so I can't really say much in terms of that. I'm trying to think what I thought about the S21 Ultra. I know I did a video on it. I think if I remember correctly, I thought the S21 Ultra had better speakers, but I can't fully remember. So I wouldn't be surprised if the older phones have better speakers, but I don't remember. Tim Grossen says, will the Vivo X Fold have Google Play Store? Thought it didn't actually. Also love the texture of leather on a phone, kind of comfy too. A good point on the leather about it being comfy. The Play Store should be installed because it does run Android 12. So it would be really strange if they had Android 12, but not the Google Play Store. So I believe, and I would put money on it, that it does come with the Google Play Store. And our last question comes from Quentin K saying, do you think the Z Fold 4 will go back to a regular selfie cam inside? I don't like the idea, but I'm hearing this. So if you're talking about the inside display, the big one, will it have under display or one that's on top? Rumors are it's still gonna be underneath, but it would be a better camera overall in terms of quality, and it would be like second generation technology. So again, it would be better. I have not heard it's gonna sit on top, so I don't think that's gonna come true. So there you guys go. That is your news for today. If you have a question, leave it in the comments down below with the word question as your first word. And that's it. Have a great day. Have a great weekend. We'll be back tomorrow with two new videos. Peace.